So previously, we took a look at the three things that we're going to need to actually start doing our Python code. We'll need somewhere for our Python code to run. We'll need something to edit it with, VS Code in our case. And then we'll need an extension for VS Code. Now those first two, Python and VS Code itself, you'll install the same way that you would install anything else onto your operating system. So I'm not going to walk through those. But I am going to walk through how to install an extension, since that will be particular to VS Code. Now, right now I've got VS Code up and running right here. And over on the right-hand side, you'll notice that there's a little icon right there, and that's my extensions. And I can actually just click right here and look through all of my extensions. And so it will show me all the ones that I have enabled. It will show me all the ones that are recommended. And I can actually just do a real quick search right here for, in my case, Python. And so it gives me Python right up at the very top. And I can actually just click install. Now, if you happen to have followed the link from the slide deck, it's really the exact same thing. It's just going to be a slightly different method. That instead of using that little spot over on the right side with VS Code, I'll just simply click install here. It will then say, hey, would you like to open this up inside of Visual Studio Code? And I'll say, as a matter of fact, yes, I would. And I click on open Visual Studio Code. And now it brings up that exact same screen that we had before, asks me would I like to install it. Well, yes, I would. I click install, and then just give it a couple of moments here to download, do the installation, and then you'll typically need to close out Visual Studio Code and reopen it in order to activate it. So I'm just going to hit close, VS Code to open it back up. Oops. And just like that, I'm ready to start writing my Python. Now, if you want to go ahead and add in a file, and we're actually going to see this in the next module, so I'm not going to steal Susan's thunder here, but you'll notice right there is the little plus file. I can click on that, and that will allow me to add in a brand new file. We'll give it a .py extension, and then start adding in our code. But again, I'm going to let Susan show that to you. What we've covered is how you can get the extension into VS Code, so that way we can actually start creating our Python code.